Hello beautiful people, how are you doing today? Hope you all are in best of your health and fantabulous as always, and as I always want you to be. So today in School for Elders, I have a story of a highly inspirational personality who is Padma Shri awardee. Yes, and she is not an Indian. Yes, she is not an Indian, she's from German, and still she has received Padma Shri, which is fourth highest civilian award. So the name of this personality is Frederick Irina Bruning. Yes, my dear friends, she is from Germany. She came in late 70s at the age of 20 in search of truth and peace. And she just stayed here from past so many years. And now she is mother to 1800 cows. And you know what? She is nurturing those cows, those who are sick, those who are just left, those who are downtrodden or on the roads, or those who are injured, right? So she is just treating them. And beauty of this story which is there is that no government agency is helping her. She is not receiving any funding from anywhere. You know what? She has done all her she has spent all her savings, whatever she has saved, whatever personal savings she was having, she has spent here, the money which she has saved in Germany, and whatever ancestral money, whatever ancestral property she was having, she is getting certain rents and certain income from there, and then she is spending that here, you know. So my dear friends, isn't it inspiring when people from India are going abroad and they are ready to do any menial job? I mean, menial job, I would not even like to mention what type of jobs they wanted to do by going there, and which they would not even touch if they are here, right? Even in their own homes, and they are ready to do there. So this lady came to India from Germany, and she is staying here, and you can check her story in Wikipedia, and you can Google her articles, how she has, it was very challenging for her, because managing visa, and she is visa, and she is not even getting work permit and all to work here, even after receiving Padma Shri. So this is really challenging for her, you know. So still she has a flair, she has focus, she has just focused on her one thing, that she said that I find solace in doing this. So the story goes like, she was here in search of truth, and somehow she bought a cow, and then she just started taking care of that cow, and then she has learned Hindi also, and then she has opened a goshala where she is taking care of so many cows, and mother to 1800 cows. So isn't it inspiring that people are coming from abroad and settling here? And it's not only her, there are many people. I personally has done Vipassana meditation in Igatpuri. There I have seen many people from abroad staying there, serving there, and very happily. So they all come here to in search of peace, love, and many of them stay here also, right? So we in this country have not discovered all the resources properly. We have not explored whatever is there, whatever heritage we are blessed with, right? तो एक बात आपको बताना चाहूँगी, इंडिया को मैक्सिमम लोग अटैक करना चाहते थे, और दे वॉन्टेड टू सर्टन एक्वायर दिस लैंड, दे वॉन्टेड टू डू सर्टन थिंग्स ऑन दिस लैंड, राइट? सो किसी चीज़ को तभी लूटा जाता है जब उसमें कोई खजाना हो, राइट? किसी खाली चीज़ को नहीं लूटा जाता, एक खाली तिजोरी को कोई नहीं खोल के मतलब और इतना कोई लॉजिकल इंसान होगा जिसने एंड वी से दैट दीज पीपल आर वेरी लॉजिकल, दे स्टडी, दे एनालाइज, ओनली देन दे डू सर्टन थिंग्स, राइट? हाउ एवर वो इंडिया को इसीलिए लूटना चाहते हैं क्योंकि हमारा कंट्री अभी भी एक गोल्डन बर्ड ही है. वी हैव ऑल द रिसोर्सेज, वी हैव ऑल द सीजन्स, राइट? एंड वी हैव एवरी थिंग, वी हैव सो मच ऑफ डाइवर्सिटी, एंड पीपल आर टेकिंग एडवांटेज. आई मीन even our own politicians are taking advantage to that matter, right? So we have to stay united and we have to be one, right? So हमें लुटना नहीं है, हमें एक होकर रहना है. We have to make this country prosperous like Japan. In Japan, people have progressed so much. Earlier, they were not having those many things. However, they just worked on their well-being. That's how their country has progressed. So first thing, we need to work on our well-being, right? So here I would like to give one more tip on your well-being. That is, I have told you yesterday, live and let live, right? So today, best thing is listening, right? When we listen to someone, we are a very good observer. When we observe things, we need to analyze. We are analyzing also. So tomorrow I will talk about something, once we observe certain things and without reacting, you can categorize those things into universal truth, generalized truth and opinionated truth, right? So I will explain about these three truths tomorrow, right? So what are these three truths? However, just whatever the person is saying, just generalizing these three statements, okay? So thank you so much for watching me and for sharing, liking and subscribing. I'm highly grateful for all your comments, for all your likes and subscribes. So see you. Take care. Bye-bye. And thank you.